Hi everyone, welcome back to Dentisend. Today we are here with a new video on gnarled enamel. We are here by continuing our lectures on the topic enamel. Enamel, which is the outermost layer of the tooth, is made up of so many enamel rods. Enamel rods is the basic structure unit of enamel, and everything in enamel revolves around these enamel rods. Even the concept of gnarled enamel is related to enamel rods. Let's see how. In the last video, we discussed the direction of enamel rods, that is, they do not run a straight course, but they run a wavy course like this. So please go through that video first so that you can understand the concept of gnarled enamel in an easier way. So these enamel rods inside the enamel, they are running a wavy course, but then suddenly there is a twist. What is the twist? So there is a twist in the direction of these enamel rods, and they become something like this. So this appearance, this twisted appearance of enamel rods, is called gnarled enamel. So let's see, let's understand what is this gnarled enamel, how it forms, where it forms, and why this twisting happens. So gnarled enamel can be your short note, or it can be part of your long question on the structure of enamel, where you have to cover all these things. We are going to cover all these topics one by one in videos. We have already discussed enamel rods, their structure, ultrastructure, and direction of rods in the previous three videos. In today's video, we are going to discuss the fourth part of this long question, that is gnarled enamel. So let's begin. Before we start, I want you to quickly subscribe to Dentisend. Please do subscribe to our channel so that this channel can grow and more students can take benefit from these videos. Also tap on the bell icon so that you remain notified about new videos. So we have discussed in the previous video, that is, enamel rods run a wavy course like this when they are inside the enamel. So these enamel rods, they start from dentino enamel junction and reach up to the tooth surface or the enamel surface, and here they run a tortuous or wavy course. Tortuous means it's not simple, it's wavy like this. So these rods, they normally run a wavy or tortuous course. So that can be seen, that can be visualized when we take horizontal or cross sections of the tooth. So when we cut thin horizontal sections or thin horizontal discs, in the adjacent discs, when these discs are cut next to each other, that is one disc and then next disc like this. So in the adjacent disc, we can see that in the first disc, enamel rods, they are starting from dentino enamel junction and they are turning towards the left side. What is happening the next disc or adjacent disc? Enamel rods are starting from dentino enamel junction only, but they are turning towards the right. So these enamel rods are changing their direction. So that means they are running a wavy course like this, which is the normal direction of enamel rods. But then here comes the twist in the direction. So what is the twist in this story? The twist is that when we cut an oblique section, that is, when we cut a section in oblique plane like this, oblique plane in the cusps and incisal regions, then the enamel rods twist around each other. As you can see here, this is the cuspal region. So they show something like this, this twisted appearance, which is known as gnarled enamel. Now, how this happens, let's understand. Let's magnify and see. This is normal direction of enamel rods. So this is one group of enamel rods, this is second group of enamel rods. In the cuspal region, these enamel rods, not only they are running a wavy course like this, but along with that, they also get twisted around each other like this. So they twist or intertwine. We have seen twister ice cream like this. So in which two flavors twist around each other like this. So similarly in this, the rods, groups of rods, one rod and another group of rods, they twist around each other. They intertwine. So these are the two words, they intertwine or they twist around each other to form a complex arrangement, as we can see here, this complex arrangement, which is known as gnarled enamel. So when we cut an oblique section, then we can see this twisting, and this is seen near dentin. This oblique plane, oblique section is cut near dentin. That is important point that you have to remember. That is enamel, when it is cut at a place which is near to dentin, where in the cusp tip region, here in the cusp tip region and in the incisal edge region. Here, these enamel rods, they twist around each other like this, as you can see here. And this is known as gnarled enamel. So let's see what you have to write for your answer on gnarled enamel and what diagram you have to make. So you can describe gnarled enamel that if discs are cut in oblique plane, especially near the cusp tip, like in the diagram we are showing, or in the incisal edge region, the enamel rod arrangement is further complicated. It's complex. So what is this complex arrangement? That is bundle of rods, they intertwine, as you can see here, they intertwine. And this is also known as twisting, twisted around each other in a complex arrangement. So this intertwining or twisting of enamel rods is known as gnarled enamel. So you have to label it as gnarled enamel. And what appearance it is? It is an optical appearance that is seen under microscope. So this optical appearance of intertwining or twisted enamel rods is known as gnarled enamel. So this is dentino enamel junction, as you can see here. This is dentino enamel junction. These are dentinal tubules, so this you can label as dentine. Then this is the enamel surface, so this is enamel surface. And then you have enamel rods, which are showing normal direction, so these are enamel rods. And the twisting is seen here in the incisal edge or cuspal tip region, which is known as your gnarled enamel. So this is your gnarled enamel. Now, why this twisting happens? Why they show this twist in the story? Why intertwining happens? Why do they need to show this arrangement, complex arrangement here? Because what is this region? This is the cuspal or incisal edge region. So what happens here? So this is the place where the maximum load occurs. That is when we chew food. So this is the place where maximum forces, maximum masticatory load happens. So to bear that load, that rods become twisted. That is, if they will be straight, imagine they are straight rods, then they can easily break whenever there is a pressure. But if these rods are twisted around each other, then they can strengthen up, and whenever load comes, they can resist it better without fracturing. So that is your next question, or why a question related to gnarled enamel, that why this twisting happens. This is to withstand masticatory load, particularly shearing forces. So that is all about gnarled enamel, and that is what you have to write and diagram that you have to make for your gnarled enamel. So let's check what you have learned about gnarled enamel. First question, gnarled enamel is seen when discs are cut in what plane? So in what plane these discs are cut? That is very, very important, the plane. Then you see gnarled enamel. Second, gnarled enamel is seen in the region of dash and dash. Where? Which region is this? Cusp tip region, incisal region, cervical region. So in which two regions this gnarled enamel is seen? Then it is seen when rods dash or dash around each other. So what is happening to rods? Those two words, two important words you have to remember. So when rods dash or dash around each other, then gnarled enamel forms. To bear what kind of load? Why this twisting happens? To what kind of forces they bear that happens in this cusp tip or incisal edge region? So I hope you got all your answers, and if you really enjoyed the video, you understood everything about gnarled enamel, do like the video and share this video with your friends as much as possible so that this channel can grow. And also keep watching, keep learning, keep smiling, and good luck for your exams. See you in the next video soon. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.